cannot be shied in a way he should go. And when he is old, he will not depart from it. The riches rule over the poor, and the borrowers is servant to the lender. He who sow iniquity will reap sorrow, and the rod of his anger will fail. He who has a generous heart will be blessed, for he gives of his bread to the poor. This is the word of God.
The epistle is written in the third chapter of Hebrews, from verse 12. Brethren, lest there be in any of you an evil heart of unbelief in departing from the living God. But exhort one another daily while it is called today, lest any of you be hardened through the deceitfulness of sin. For we are made partakers of Christ if we hold the beginning of our confidence steadfast unto the end. While it is said, today, if you will hear his voice, harden not your hearts as in the provocation. For some, when they had heard, did provoke, albeit not all that came out of Egypt by Moses. But with whom was it grieved 40 years? Was it not with them that had sinned, whose carcasses fell in the wilderness? And to whom swear he that they should not enter into his rest? But to them that believed not. So we see that they could not come in because of unbelief. This is the word of God.
Gospel of our Lord Jesus Christ, as recorded by St. Mark, chapter 10, beginning at verse 13. Glory to Christ our Savior. One day, some parents brought their children to Jesus so he could touch and bless them. But the disciples called at the parents for bothering him. When Jesus saw what was happening, he was angry with his disciples. He said to them, "Let the children come to me. Don't stop them, for the kingdom of God belongs to those who are like these children. I tell you the truth, anyone who doesn't receive the kingdom of God like a child will never enter it." Then he took the children in his arms and placed his hands on their heads and blessed them. This is the gospel of Christ. Praise to Christ our Lord.
Let us pray. Our Heavenly Father, we thank you for yet another privilege to be before your presence. Thank you for your awesome presence, which has been a blessing to us. Thank you, O Lord, for your love and care over our souls. Lord, here we are before you. Father, we trust in you, O Lord, to speak to us. The word that will bring transformation to our lives. The word that will strengthen us. The word, O Lord, that will bring healings to our sick bodies. Holy Spirit, take us through control of every word that we're going to speak and hear. And at the end, your name alone shall be glorified. The name of God the Father, God the Son, and God the Holy Spirit. Amen. Praise the Lord. I want to thank God Almighty who has kept us alive and then brought us to another Lenten season. May his name be praised forever in the name of Jesus. I want to thank on a special note our Father in the Lord and Mama Baba Surulele and Mama Surulele, the Venerable Jimmy Ebisuwa, our Archdeacon. I want to thank him so much for your love, for your care, your hospitality, encouragement to us, and all those serving under you. The Lord will continue to bless your family. The Lord will continue to lift you high in Jesus' name. And all other clergy serving in this church, your ministry will continue to experience God's love in Jesus' name. People of God, I want to welcome each and every one of you, and I pray that Almighty God will meet you at the points of your needs in Jesus' name. As we continue with the theme for this year's Lenten season, building our children's feet. If you have the pamphlet, it will help you to understand more about this theme. Advice you get one of it. We shall take our text from the Proverbs 22, verse 6. Proverbs 22, verse 6. Train up a child in the way he should go, and when he's old, he will not depart from it. This is the word of the Lord. We sincerely thank God because the topic for today says the Sunday school, a sustainable tool for child development. The topic for today is the Sunday school, a sustainable tool for child development. And when we look at the introductory part of it, the Sunday school, also called children's service. In some of our churches, we refer to Sunday school as children's service. It's also a school for spiritual education of children and young people, and usually a part of a parish. It is the fundamental stage for the spiritual and moral development. The Sunday school places a focus on biblical education, while supporting the elementary academic, the teaching children receive during their weekly school education. Their spiritual development platform is designed to be used as a tool to support the ministerial effort as we help to support the child's spiritual development. The kids through Sunday school will benefit from a resource dedicated to assisting them to develop insight into biblical principle. Having read through this, we talk about Sunday school as a training ground for church members, particularly the children. After they are converted, what I mean by conversion in this aspect, after they receive the sacrament of baptism, after they have been baptized, which is the initial rite of the church, into her membership, also a sign and seal of this new birth through faith in Christ Jesus, an adoption into God's family. Then they are taught the main teaching of the church. And that is when we now enroll them in Sunday school. The lessons of Sunday school are prepared in such a way that they emphasize the main Christian doctrine and practices. And this is the reason why it's very important for our children to start from Sunday school, so they can learn the principles, the practices, the agricanism, their doctrines, and all the nature of our services and everything about agricanism. When we talk about to train them up in the way of the Lord, the Bible encourages us to do that. From the passage we read, we talk about to prepare them physically and mentally in order to become ready for some events in Christian life. We prepare their spiritual life, we prepare them physically, mentally, and then they will grow and mature in their Christian life. To teach them new skills, give the necessary preparation so that they will reach the standard and they will grow and mature in their Christian faith. When we talk about Christian faith, I always like to be specific about this. Agricanism, our agrican doctrine, we should pay more attention to that. That we ought to teach our children all this. When you talk about the role of Sunday school in our churches, in our various parishes, the diligent teaching of the Bible will do emphasis on application. This is what they do in our Sunday school. Not only that, they are teaching them the Bible, but we do emphasis on application. So when they grow, they will live by it. What they have learned, what they are taught, the way we model them. When they grow, they will live with it. Allow the children to achieve an encounter with the living God. At this stage, don't say they are too young. They are tender. At this stage, it's good and important that we should allow them to achieve an encounter with the living God. Let them have an encounter with the living God. Who say that a little boy, a girl of 5 years, cannot give their life to Christ? It's possible. It depends on how we expose them to these teachings and doctrines. Allow the children to do this. Say, at this level, say, we should try to lead them to Christ. That this slogan I love so much, that catch them young for Christ. Them young. Let us be more serious with their spiritual life. It's good to send them to school. It's good to send them to many places and to buy everything for them just to make them comfortable. But their spiritual life is of very, very importance. May God help us in Jesus' name. When they are enrolled in this children's service or Sunday school, the Sunday school becomes the mechanism to shaping the child's spirituality. When you take them to this Sunday school, allow them to be there, they will shape in the child's spirituality emotionally and academically, as the case may be. It affords them the time to present the gospel in a way that children can understand. Bring it down to their level. I want to show you, if there is any child here, maybe the level we operate and what we say here, you may find it difficult to comprehend. But if you allow them to go to Sunday school, it's fun. You teach them the word of God with fun. You see them dancing, singing, and that is the only way to indoctrinate them for Christ. Then, it affords them the time to present the gospel, to tackle age-appropriate life issues, and to apply the scripture to those things. There are things, the life we live, the life they live as children, through scriptural teachings, those things, the Ten Commandments, thou shalt not steal. And now tell them why they must not steal. They must not lie. Tell them the reason why they should not lie. All these things we have to tackle the age-appropriate life issues as they apply the scriptures. To have spiritual conversation that may end up transforming the life of the child. By the time through prayer, study, and their life will be transformed spiritually, you discover that this child has become a change agent, a change person. Now, how do we do this in our Sunday schools? We need to equip these Sunday schools. They are here. We need teaching aids to pass these teachings to our children. Teaching aids are very important. Like all these smart TVs and projectors, they are very important. We have the audiovisual Bibles. We have these audiovisual Bibles, lessons with pictures, which contains Bible overviews. Look, from creation story to the birth and ministry of Jesus Christ, you project it, you show them the pictures, how all these things came to be. Though to us, it's just a picture to us, but to them, they see the facts in those pictures, and they will grow up with these stories, rooted in them. Anytime you talk about it, they will remember those stories. The audiovisual Bible has series with Bible stories for evangelism and systematic Christian teaching. Like book 1 to book 8, with varieties, the Bible stories like Adam, Noah, Job, Abraham, and so on. That is for evangelism. When you begin to teach them from this level, the story of Adam, the story of Abraham, Noah, Job, and you see, they will look at these people as the role model. They will lie to live, to fashion their life in a way that these people have demonstrated their faith in God. We have Jacob, Joseph, Moses, and that is in book 2. We have Joshua, Deborah, Gideon, Samson, and so on. That's in book 3. All these things are pointed to evangelism. And then we have what I call look, listen, and live, the flip chart. All these things are teaching us, needed for our Sunday school. So these children can learn fast, and they will also enjoy their learning and teaching. Digital Bible pictures pack encompass Genesis through the early New Testament church and the stories of St. Paul. All these things are there. The music. These children, they learn by music. Teach them Christian music and also interpret these things to them. So when they praise God, you will see the beauty of praises in them. On the school manual, we learn content section for the day's teaching, whether outline, which outlines the Bible story in language that is easy for children to understand and include Bible references. All these things are the teaching aids we are needed for us to build up their spiritual life. We are talking about Sunday school a sustainable tool for children development. Very, very important. Then we talk about the teachers. Talk about the teachers. The Sunday school should be manned by good teachers who should possess the following qualities. In the page 22 of our pamphlet, there are 8 qualities needed or this Sunday school teacher should possess. I just mentioned 3 of them. Said a heart of God. A teacher that mans a Sunday school must have the heart of God. Then a passion for God's word. You cannot give out what you don't have. They must have passion for word of God. And an ability to teach. This will help them to develop these children spiritually. There are 8 of them. You can read through all the whole 8. This course for training and the retraining of our Sunday school teachers is 2 Timothy 2 verse 15. 2 Timothy 2 verse 15, there he said, we should be diligent in learning and also teaching these young ones. Not only to equip them on what the Anglican Church is all about, but also to learn the art of imparting knowledge to the children at this tender age. And this is where I will always advise that our teachers, from time to time, they will go for this training and retraining program. They must be rooted. They must know, have the knowledge and understanding of agricanism. As they teach this children, they will impart this thing on, infuse it in on the system. So they will grow up with them. So they will be sound. We have them in our services, we see them, they will perform incredibly well because they are taught with this method. And then, some of the key benefits of Sunday school are also listed here. An additional Bible teaching, supplementing what is being taught at home. Yes, at home, the parents, we have done our own part by raising them, giving them good moral teachings, advices. Based on the school, we help to complement, to supplement all these things and help, you know, nurture and help build up their spiritual life. Practicing the habit of listening to God's word, studying and prayers. That is when they will practice this. That bit of listening to God's word. Some of our children, that they are always, that if you see, they come into the church, they're outside, they run here and there, helter skater. But when you teach them, the teachers know how they will compel them to sit down and listen. And you'll be surprised that this child that hardly stay one place, you will see him seated quiet and listening to the word of God. That is what the Sunday school can do. See, Christian children developing healthy friendship with other Christian children. Yes, they will mix up with other Christian children and they will learn together. May God help us to nurture our children in the way of the Lord in Jesus' name. And then, we talk about the Sunday school as a school. And we know in school we have what we call PTA, Parent Teachers Association. There is the need for parents to have a close relationship with Sunday school teachers to bring out the best in the life of our children. Sunday school teachers and parents have a responsibility in educating children to be obedient and faithful to God. Now, I said it, from time to time, parents, we make our time, visit this Sunday school, interact with these teachers, and know how you will be of help. Or better still, you meet the vicar to find out the needs of our children department, many of us, we don't know that this is the most vital department that can build the church. So from time to time, go there and know how you can help out. The Lord will provide for us in Jesus' name. Now, a child development should be a holistic one. When a child development is focused only on academic abilities, that child does not develop the complete set of skills. They need to become satisfied, successful adults. Not only that, they will develop the complete set of skills, but they will be satisfied and become a successful adult. Many of our fathers in the Lord, they begin from this Sunday school, children church, and there they were not sure they were models. And many of them can testify to that, what they learned from this Sunday school. They may be able to read and write, but what about expressing emotion and taking care of their bodies? What about their morals and other virtues that they need to fit into the society? Very, very important. What we witness the society today is a total, the system has collapsed. You see the children, they behave, I mean, the way and the manner they embrace corruption and immoral acts so much. The talk of them today is Yahoo this and Yahoo that. And they have their models. They want to be like them. They will see big cars and they want to ride this car. A child that is still in the secondary school stage, he wants to ride the best car. And this is what we have witnessed in this generation. May God help us that our children be not shut in the will of the Lord, in the mighty name of Jesus. There is need for continuous assessment. The kind of test or exam, like when from time to time the Sunday school department, it will assess the strength and weakness of these children. There are questions they ought to ask them to know if they actually getting what they are taught. What makes you want to become? These questions are in verse 24. You go there and you read through all these things. There are about 10 of them. So may God help us as we talk about Sunday school, a sustainable tool for child development, that our Sunday school to be spiritually filled in Jesus' name. Finally, the Dawson Bishop, the Right Reverend King Paul Johnson, in his 2022 Synod Presenter's Charge, declared us, he listed 7-point agenda to improve our Sunday school. The 7-point agenda is 25, but let me just read some of them. He said, apart from the regular visitation of the Sunday schools by vicars, there are other practical steps that might be taken to improve our Sunday schools. And these we list in no particular order. One, the environment of their corporate worship must be conducive with enough space and ventilation. Where we have enough space, we should space them. And we should have classes for them. 2 years to 3 years, 4 to 6, 6 to 8. And then, by so doing, they will be learned. They learn from that stage. And you know, sir, it is important that when they break into their various classes, they must adequately spaced out. Yes. And you see, the printed materials for worship and teaching aid for study must be provided. We have said that before. As much as possible, a clergyman must lead them or be present at their corporate worship, which must reflect Anglican liturgy. I have emphasized on this much. Anglican liturgy. Our children at age of 10
know how to conduct Martin's service. At age of 12, 13, 14, even at age of 15, they can conduct antique communal service. In some denominations, you will see their children, the way they do it. So we should inculcate this in our children, the habit. For them to know that this is not only for adults, they can do it. The teacher should be interviewed before being allowed to teach, and they must be legally trained. I've said that before. And then he said, the last one, the vicars must regularly incorporate the Sunday school with the adult church. For instance, during Holy Communion service, inviting all the children forward to receive a blessing at the altar. The children must not be chased away from the altar. The Sunday school should, on special occasions such as Mother's Sunday and Father's Day, be allowed to lead or participate in the services. The formation of children choir or drama groups is to be encouraged. Of course, we have those ones in our church. But where I want to comment more is to allow them in some of our special services to come and conduct. Of course, in some churches, there are some particular Sundays dedicated to them where we handle every aspect of the services. It helps them to grow. It helps them to feel, to have sense of belonging. You don't chase them away. Even when they have their department, like in some churches, they have what we call a teenager's church. From time to time, we monitor them. We know what they are doing. And then we try to put them right. Finally, before we pray, say, finally, through the Sunday school, engineers, doctors, generals, bishops, captains of industries, and much more are produced. John 1, verse 4. We must ensure the quality we produce from the word goes. And when we don't produce spiritually and morally sound children, we seem to have failed both God and humanity. May we never fail God and humanity in Jesus' name. May God help us to train these children in the way of the Lord, that when they grow, they will never depart from it. Our children will be a great asset in our lives in Jesus' name. In our families, they shall be celebrated. They shall be a source of joy. They will be a blessing to us. And they will never be a cost to us in Jesus' name. Let us pray. Heavenly Father, we thank you for the word that has spoken to us. We thank you, O Lord, for your grace, for your love, most especially on our children. Father, in the book of Proverbs, we are asked to train them in the way of the Lord. Father, we pray that the life of these children will continue to glorify your name in the mighty name of Jesus.
ni olorun anu olorun ti sanu olorun ti anu re duro lai lai e je ka dupe lowo re fun owo in accordance with my sin. I adore you. I lift your name high, the God of mercy. That the God of mercy, the one who loved us and sent his son to die for the sins of the whole world. Can you thank him this evening? Thank him for the peace that we enjoy in our nation, Nigeria. Despite how turbulent our elections are, that God has given us peace. Let's pray that, Lord, there will be no disaster in this land, that there will be no bloodshed in every region of this nation. Lord, we commit to you that, Lord, the innocent will not die. That we pray for the gubernatorial election coming up on Saturday. The Lord, it will be peaceful in the name of Jesus. We continue to pray for leaders that you will choose in this nation. That you will plant your fear in them. May they rule, may they lead, may they govern with your fear and your knowledge. Omo Olorun ma je ka gbagbe ka gbadura faran olori ti a fe yan ati ri wi pe owo ki gba ni ogbon ti ko toke wa asan ni karanti awon olori wa ni adura wa loni ka gbadura wi pe Oluwa awon olori to ni iberu re to ni ife awon arakunrin atarabirin won ni ki eyan fun wa ka gbadura for INEC wa ton se akoso idibo ati gbogbo awon tin sise nibe ki won fi okan tooto ki won fi se ise na ohun to ma ba idibo na ru Baba, e ma je kan towo si. E wa je ka gbadura fun ara wa. Ka gbadura wi pe Oluwa, lomi. E lomi. Ki le ko awon omo mi ni ona yin baba. Boya Oluwa ti fun won lori ofe, o ti ri awon omo re. Gbadura loni wipe Oluwa fun mi ni agbara fun mi ni oye ki le ko won gege bi ase re Genesis chapter 18 verse 19 says and I know that Abraham will command his children in the way of the Lord. Have you failed in that responsibility? This is the time of mercy. Say, Lord, help me. What I need to be diligent, to commit, and to continue to do, to teach my children in the fear of the Lord. Father, grant to me in the name of Jesus. And this evening, children of God, I want us to pray that the Lord will bless every one of us. He said, when God created us, he blessed man. He said, be fruitful, multiply, and have dominion. Can you pray tonight, the Lord, I have appeared in your house. I look up to you, my God and my Lord. Bless me, increase me, multiply me in the name of Jesus. I want us to remember couples that are looking up to God for the fruit of the womb, that we stand in gap for them today. The Lord, the joy of children, you will bless this your servant with in the name of Jesus. Your word said, none shall be barren in the land. We speak, our God and our Father, to all who are waiting on you, our God and our Lord, that you will open their womb. The Lord, even for the male, you will empower them that they will be fertile, they will be fruitful on all sides in the name of Jesus. If there is any cause, if there is any medical condition, Father, we look up unto you today. Father, intervene. Let your miraculous power, Father, do the wonders in their lives. Lord, in your mercy. Beloved, the Lord is asking you this evening, what do you want me to do for you? You have come to this Lenten service. Can you talk to God? Or you are here, you are pained. You want to make a vow to your God. With this God, nothing, absolutely nothing is impossible. Are you discouraged? Are you looking for a job? Are you looking for a life partner? Is your marriage turbulent? Can you talk to God? The one who hears our silent prayer like a loud cry. Are you pressed hard by the economy? Everything you seem to lay your hand upon seem not to go well. Can you talk to him? He will perform his miracle again. Talk to him. Have faith in him. With him, nothing, absolutely nothing, is impossible. Lord, in your mercy, Almighty God, the fountain of all wisdom, who knows our necessity before we act and our ignorance and action, we pray you to have compassion upon our infirmities and those things which are worthiness we dare not, and for blindness we cannot ask, vouchsafe to give us for the worthiness of your Son, Jesus Christ, our Lord. So, beloved, at this time, the gift of stewards will help us as we bring our Evensong collection, and also for those of us who are bringing our self-denial envelopes, as we take the next hymn, the gift of stewards will collect. And for those who want to use the online means, that part is on item 3 on our bulletin.
And so, our Heavenly Father, we thank you. We thank you for this opportunity that you have given unto us to bring before you our even song offering, our self-denial offering. We ask, oh God, that you continually help us to indeed deny ourselves, oh God, and take up our cross, oh God, to follow you in the name of Jesus. Help us, oh God, to present our bodies as a living sacrifice, holy and acceptable unto you, Lord, in the name of Jesus. We ask, oh God, that you bless this offering. Lord, it will be used for the expansion of your work here on earth in the name of Jesus. And the blessings of giving shall continually be our portions. Thank you, Father, because we know you have answered us. In Jesus Christ's mighty name we have prayed.
The Lord be with you. Can we please have a seat once again in the name of our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ? I welcome every one of us to this lengthened service. Can you help me shake the person beside you and say, it is nice to see you in church? We thank you all for coming, and we appreciate you, and we pray that the blessings that you have received will go home with you in the name of Jesus. We want to especially welcome our Father in God, our preacher from All Saints Anglican Church, Surulere, the Reverend Azubike Omwason. Can we jam our hands as we welcome him? So, what are we saying to him? We thank God for your life, sir, and for God using you. And we pray that the Lord will continue to anoint you and use you for greater works in the name of Jesus. I want us to remember that there are still copies of the Lenten manual. I know the Guild of Stewards, okay, they already is at the back. If you want a copy, I think it's just 250 naira. And like I said, if there are people who want to buy for others, you can please, you know, use it, buy so that it will make an impact. I want to thank our brother who had spoken to us today about the importance of Sunday school. Me, myself, I'm a product of Sunday school. So what it means, I think from what he has said that has challenged us, is also even good for us sometimes to even go and worship there, to even see how the children are worshiping. Sometimes it could just be that what they need is a modern day board that can be used. What stops them from having their computers in the Sunday school? Because teaching children now has taken a new dimension. And I think that all of us, we are challenged to see that we equip a Sunday school. You know, if they want to come and learn the story of David, what stops them for us sending those things to them or do a cartoon for them to just come and draw who Goliath is or who David, you know, is or what it represents in the Bible? We can even have people here, young people, youth, who can do a cartoon or a play that they can watch and understand. There are better ways we adults can help the children to understand. They can sing the song, put the story in a song. There are many things we as parents can do to help and support our Sunday school teacher. One of it that we also need in this church, we need a male Sunday school teacher. I know since when my brother Niyi Akinjogbe left, we are still looking for a male teacher. Thank God, I think Bro Tunde Ono has joined them. So please, we make an appeal We are looking for more male Sunday school teachers that will come into the Sunday school. Okay, you can look at the person beside you. It could be you they are talking about. No, say to the person in your hair, male and female we will take, but if male come, you know. So please, if you know that God has blessed you with that gift, please don't shy away from it. Let God use you to bless the children. Once again, I want to thank the choir master. Thank you so much. I want to thank our choir. Can we jam our hands for our choir? This is really impressive to have you here. The Lord will continue to bless you in the name of Jesus. Okay, for those who have not taken, I think I gave them the Sunday school, the manual last week. Is that not so? So, okay, if there are still young of you that have not collected, okay, I still have more of those manuals to give. We appreciate you, our choir master. Thank you, the Gate of Stewards, our ICT team. Let's appreciate our ICT team. They are doing a great job. The sound technicians, the sexings, the cleaner, our security team, all who have worked behind the scene. We pray for you. The Lord who sees in secret will bless you and reward you in the name of Jesus. The Lord be with you. Let us pray. Can we commit our ways to God as we go out this evening? Are you troubled, worried, or sorrowful? Can you ask for the peace of God that passeth all understanding? Say, Lord, bring stillness and calmness to my soul. You have promised that you will lead us to the still and quiet waters. Say, Lord, calm my troubled soul. Calm my troubled soul. The peace of God, which passes all understanding, keep your heart and mind in the knowledge and love of God and of His Son, Jesus Christ, our Lord, and the blessing of the eternal Trinity, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit, rest and abide with you, and all those dear to you wherever they may be, now and forevermore.